SpaceX has moved the whole rocket industry in a different direction. Previously, the rocket boosters used to splash down in the ocean, then refurbished again from scratch, rebuilt, and then launched again. But now, after SpaceX came into the rocket industry, and after landing the first batches of rockets, they completely changed the whole industry with great technology and reusability. They have recovered more than 70 orbital-class rocket boosters to date, but they have a different plan for the recovery of Super Heavy Booster. So let's discuss why and how SpaceX will recover the Super Heavy Booster in today's video of DiscoverZen. SpaceX has done many jaw-dropping things in the past. They have won against all odds whenever it comes to booster landing, especially for Falcon 9. And this time again, they are going to try something very ambitious with their new Starship. Before moving forward to all the technical details, let's look at what Starship is and how it is different from any other rocket ever flown. SpaceX Starship spacecraft and Super Heavy rocket, collectively referred to as Starship, represents a fully and rapidly reusable transportation system designed to carry both crew and cargo to the Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars, and beyond. There will be six variants of the Starship. Number 1. Crewed Starship. This variant is the most important version of all the types. This rocket will carry up to around 100 passengers and can be operated for long distances, such as the Moon, Mars, and beyond. Number 2. The Cargo Starship. In this variant, the rocket's bay doors will open like a large jaw crocodile. It will be having a stunning 1,000 cubic meters of usable space for goods and cargo. Number 3. The Tanker Starship. This version of the rocket will be used for an on-orbit refueling, which will reduce the cost of Starship's operation. Number 4. The One-Way Starship. This variant won't be developed in the near future, but SpaceX has plans to build it in the long term as technology improves. The rocket will only be made to inject payloads into the outer solar system. Number 5. The Lunar Starship. This rocket will only be used for lunar missions. The rocket will only stay in space between the Earth and the Moon. This version of the Starship won't have the large flaps or heat shields as it won't be re-entering the Earth's atmosphere. Number 6. Earth Transport. This rocket will be used for point-to-point travel throughout Earth. Starship is not only the name of a full rocket, but also to the upper stage. The name of the first stage, which is where the booster stays, is Super Heavy. It's made up of stainless steel and stands 120 meters or 394 feet tall. That Starship uses new Raptor engines for every stage. The Raptor is the most ambitious engine ever created in the history of mankind. It is powered by subcooled liquid methane and subcooled liquid oxygen using the stage combustion cycle, unlike the simpler open cycle gas generator system. To know more about those sweet Raptor engines or Starship in general, click on that I button or check out the link in the description below. So how will the booster landing of Starship be different from the Falcon 9 rockets? For that, first, let's take a close look at the Falcon 9 and its landing. Falcon 9 is a reusable two-stage rocket designed and manufactured by SpaceX for the reliable and safe transport of people and payloads into Earth orbit and beyond. It is the world's first orbital-class reusable rocket. Reusability allows SpaceX to refly the most expensive parts of the rocket, which in turn drives down the cost of space access. Falcon 9 is 70 meters or 229.6 feet tall, with a mass of 549,000 kilograms and a diameter of 3.7 meters or 12 feet. This has a payload capacity of 8,300 kilograms or 18,300 pounds for the geostationary transfer orbit. Merlin. This is a family of rocket engines developed by SpaceX for use on its Falcon 1, Falcon 9, and Falcon Heavy launch vehicles. Merlin engines use rocket-grade kerosene, RP1, and liquid oxygen as rocket propellants in a gas generator power cycle. The Merlin engine was originally designed for that holy grail of recovery and reuse. Falcon 9 is a two-stage, LOX RP1 powered heavy lift launch vehicle. The first stage is equipped with four landing legs made of state-of-the-art carbon fiber with an aluminum honeycomb. The 9 Merlin engines on this first stage are gradually throttled near the end of the first stage flight to limit launch vehicle acceleration as the rocket's mass decreases with the burning of fuel. These engines are also used to reorient the first stage prior to re-entry and to decelerate the vehicle for landing. And just for reference, the second stage is powered by a single Merlin vacuum engine and delivers Falcon 9's payload to the desired orbit. The second stage engine ignites a few seconds after stage 1 separation and can be restarted multiple times to place multiple payloads into different orbits. And for it to land, it will require lower levels of fuel to burn during re-entry. Because of this reason, it has to do with something called suicide burn. That is, precisely firing up the engines so that the velocity becomes zero exactly before the touchdown. And this is part of where the super heavy booster of Starship differs from Falcon 9. SpaceX will attempt to catch the heavy booster, which is currently in development, using the same launch tower arm that's used to stabilize the vehicle during its pre-takeoff preparations. The Super Heavy launch process will still involve the use of its engines to control the velocity of its descent, but it will involve using the grid fins that are included on its main body to help control its orientation during flight to catch the booster, essentially hooking it using the launch tower arm before it touches the ground at all. The main benefit of this method, which obviously will involve a lot of precision maneuvering, is that it means SpaceX can save both cost and weight by omitting landing legs from the Super Heavy design altogether. Another potential benefit raised by Musk is that it could allow SpaceX to essentially recycle the Super Heavy booster immediately back on the launch mount it returned to, possibly enabling it to be ready to fly again with a new payload and upper stage in about an hour. If this sounds too far-fetched, think about everything SpaceX has achieved thus far, and you'll start seeing it's a likely possibility. It's no secret that Musk is planning more than one trip to Mars, so a quick recycle of a booster will allow for these trips to happen by speeding up the time it takes for a new space mission to take off. That is ultimately the goal of Starship and Super Heavy. Suborbital test flights of the Starship have already begun, but there's been a few issues. The first two suborbital test flights ended up engulfed in flames upon landing. However, this did not deter Elon Musk. The CEO also said that he expects to begin flight testing two prototype Super Heavy boosters in as soon as a few months at the SpaceX facility in Boca Chica, Texas. With our current technology, a Mars civilization seems far-fetched, but once SpaceX develops and perfects Starship launch and Super Heavy landing, we will see humans stepping onto Mars within just a few years. Now let's see how SpaceX Starlink is gonna change the way we all use the internet. Well, actually, we should probably go ahead and save that for next time on DiscoverZen.